Praise the Lord, everyone. Brother Rupe here with Sister Gretchen.
Hello.
If you're a subscriber, thank you very much. We're honored and privileged. If you like these short videos, devotions, go ahead and subscribe and ring the bell. Today's devotional is called Humility.
Yes, something we all need a whole lot more of.
Especially me.
Not more than me. Humility. Luke 18:14 says, "Everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted."
Yes, that's Jesus speaking.
I know, you know, and it's just amazing how we could never exalt ourselves to the level that Jesus desires to exalt us. But you have to lose so much of yourself.
Right.
For the Lord to be willing to do that, you know, you really have to become almost nothing for Jesus to want to be yes. able to exalt you in a way he would love to be able to exalt you. But right. the minute we start doing it ourselves, Jesus takes his hands off of us.
Right.
And we will pay consequences for it.
Right.
So here's the lesson for today.
Amen.
The worshipful heart will have its struggles. One of the greatest is combating the natural human desire to establish our own success, status, and security. We easily become self-focused, wanting to become good in order to represent God well. Guess what? God doesn't need any help.
He don't need no help.
No.
Not from us, eh?
No. Have we forgotten? God is already represented well by Jesus, especially in the company of lepers, sinners, and thieves on a cross. Yeah. The selfward heart doesn't get it. It can't be transparent about its weaknesses and failures because it is too busy making them. There is a personal reputation to maintain. The Godward heart, however, is busy with God's reputation. Yeah, the Godward heart is not putting itself first. It's putting God's first. God first. It can easily confess sin and sickness because it knows that God is glorified by his treatment of such things. The selfward soul runs around saying, "I'm doing my best for the glory of God." The Godward soul can relax and proclaim, "God is doing his wonderful work in the wreck that is me."
Right.
Such a big difference. Such a big difference.
We're all train wrecks to a certain
yes,
degree.
Yes, we are.
Just a matter of how many cars are off the track.
How much baggage are you towing around?
Right.
The less baggage, the less wreckage. Right. Ooh, imagine that. Both perspectives come from good intentions.
Yeah.
But deep in the heart of man is a reluctance to embrace God's reputation at the expense of our own.
Yes.
Boy, that is so true.
Very true.
We don't want to own up to our weaknesses, failures, brokenness, and sin. We want to demonstrate God's grace in our respectable lives. Again, that's putting ourselves before God. God's grace shows up best in the honesty of the tax collector like Zacharias or a prostitute that weeps for mercy.
Ooh, yeah.
Honest souls know what's inside of them. They alone can showcase a Savior.
Ooh, yeah, that's deep. Ooh.
It's very deep.
That's very revealing, too.
It is.
If you're not worshiping your God, I mean, are you revealing yourself, your true nature? You might be hiding something.
Yeah, we think we're hiding stuff, but usually people around us see it, and we're just blind to it.
Yeah, the people who worship the hardest are usually the ones who have been forgiven the most. That's my experience. So.
And we all need forgiveness.
All of us, yeah.
Yeah. This parable isn't just about Pharisees. It's about all of us. Do you really want to worship God with every aspect of your being? Then let Him be your everything, your Savior, Healer, Provider, Judge, Refuge, and Strength. Acknowledging your ultimate dependence and need isn't always easy. It will require honesty before Him and an honest testimony before the world. Will that reflect well on you? Probably not. I know it won't for me. There's no probably about it. But it will reflect incredibly well on Him, God. Yes. And that's what worship is all about.
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah, if we're honest, we can be an amazing testimony for the Lord in what He did for us. Not what we did for ourselves.
Yes.
Not what anyone else did for us, but what God did.
Right.
Yeah, I was just, we were just talking a few minutes ago. We took a little break from videos, took a little break from Facebook because I wasn't in a good place for most of February. I had a lot of emotional stuff going on. And, you know, I thought, man, it's better just to be quiet than potentially let my emotions get the best of me.
Amen.
And put stuff out there. It was good for this guy, too, trust me. I just needed to be quiet, you know, because if my mouth would have spoken my thoughts and emotions, we would not be in a good place right now. And it's nothing Bill did. It's nothing anyone else did to me. It's just me going through just an emotional roller coaster.
Yeah, we all go through them.
You know?
We all go through them.
And yeah.
I get melancholy once in a while.
Yeah. You know? I was emotional about it being the anniversary of my dad's death. I was emotional about selling one of my houses. I was emotional about being turned down to go back and serve as a missionary in Guatemala. And man, it all hit at the same time. And it's like, oh my goodness, I need to just be quiet because my words would have gotten me in trouble. But fortunately, I had this amazing man by me who just stood there. Let me cry when I needed to cry. Yeah. He let me get a little, you know, out there when I needed to be out there. He didn't make it personal, nope. Which is really what I need mostly. It's just, look, it's not you. It's definitely me, but just hang tight. We'll get through it together.
Yes.
So I hope all of you are having a blessed Sunday. And we thank y'all for watching our videos. We love comments. We love questions. God bless y'all.
Thank you.